A very good day to all of you. Computer Shiksha is supported by. Until now, you all have learnt about the basics of Paint 1, Writer 1, Impress 1, and Calci or Spreadsheet 1. Let us now begin learning about Internet. Do you know what is Internet? Internet is a source of information from all across the world, and you can easily access all this information. Depending on what you need, you can get the information from the Internet. This provides a link to information from all across the globe. Why do we use the Internet? As you know, with the help of Internet, you can get information sitting on a computer from any other computer connected to the Internet. You can share data and files from different computers if the other computers permit you to do so. With the help of Internet, you can communicate amongst different computers connected to the Internet and can also chat with each other. You can use the Internet to perform many such tasks. Let us now know how you can make use of the Internet. In today's world, there is hardly anyone who would not be using the Internet in some way or the other. Based on our requirements, Internet provides us with the information we seek. There are many ways to connect with the Internet. These include Ethernet cable, broadband, hotspots, dial-up, satellite, ISDN. You can also get connected using ISP or Internet Service Provider. Let us now learn about the different types of networks like LAN, WAN, MAN. Let us first know about LAN. You get to use the LAN network through an Ethernet cable, and this is mostly used in offices, schools, universities, and many other such places. These are all local area networks in which the computers are linked through servers. The server can be thought of as a program or a device which provides internet access to all the linked computers or the clients through a cable. Such an internet connection offers speeds of 10 megabytes to 1 gigabyte. Let's now learn about WAN. The full form of WAN is Wide Area Network, and the coverage area of WAN is larger than LAN. These networks are spread all across the world, and computers and phones are linked to it. This is mostly used for mobile phones and landlines. WANs offer wider coverage and has speeds of 10 megabytes to 100 megabytes. For example, GSM, CDMA, and bank ATM networks use WAN to interconnect the various branches of the banks. Let us now learn about MAN. MAN stands for Metropolitan Area Network. Its coverage area is like that of a LAN for a city. As such, its coverage is more than a LAN but less than a WAN. It offers speeds of 10 megabytes to 100 megabytes, and it is used like a city cable network. Let us next learn about Wi-Fi networks. The full form of Wi-Fi is wireless internet for frequent interface. And using this, we can connect our computer or mobile phone to the internet. You do not need a wire for this. DSL is short for Digital Subscriber Line interface, where you can connect to the internet using the telephone wire. This two-wire interface helps us transmit voice and data. Thus, DSL is also an option to connect to the internet. Hotspot is a new technology using which you can connect your computer and phone both to the internet. You would have seen many people using the hotspot technology to connect to the internet. Let us now learn about the browser. You must be wondering as to what is a browser. Browser is a software program which helps us in viewing web pages on our computers. Browser serves as a link for our computer to the internet and helps users surf the internet and make use of it. There are many types of browsers like Internet Explorer, Google Chrome, Mozilla Firefox, and Opera, etc. These are all different types of browsers. However, in Windows, there is a predefined browser which is called the Internet Explorer. And you can even download all these browsers from the internet. Whenever you open a browser, the page that opens is called the web page. On the top, it has a title bar. The title bar tells us the name of the web page. The browser also has some options or menus using which you can manage your browser. These are like File, Edit, View, etc. You can learn more about their usage by watching the video. Let us now watch this video to learn more about using the menu bar. So we first open the Internet Explorer, the browser for Internet Explorer, as is being shown in the video. So once we get the Internet Explorer browser, we click on that and you can see a screen opens for the Internet Explorer. Now to see the menus on this, you need to press the Alt button. And as soon as you press the Alt button, you see these menus here, File, Edit, View. So the first one is for File. Here there are many options for New Tab. So you can click on New Tab and you can see that a new tab opens for you. If you don't need it right now, you can just click here and close it. So the next option, once again, you need to press Alt to show the menus. Click on File and you can see there is a tab for Duplicate tab. If you click on Duplicate tab, a tab which was already open, a similar tab will open up for you. So this way you can have a duplicate tab also. Click on the cross to close it. The other file menu options are also shown here. For instance, you have new session, open, save as, close tab, print. So there are many options available and you can use these options from here. Print preview, send, properties, and also exit. The next option, the next menu is for edit. With edit, you can do usual work like cut, copy, paste, anything that you want from here. You can do a select all. And also you can use this find on this page option to find any word or text on this particular page. So you can use the find. Control plus F is the shortcut command for this. The next option is for view menu. The view menu gives you options first for the toolbars. So the menu bar, the favorite bar, command bar, status bar, and lock the toolbars. That these are the options available. So you can either hide or show by clicking here. So click on the favorites and favorite bar, and it will also be shown to you. So this is how you can use the toolbars options. Then in the view menu itself, once we have clicked on favorite, you can see favorite option has come. In the other options of the view menu, if you look at go to, there are you can go back by clicking. If you click on home page, you go back to the beginning of the home page or the browser's home page. Then you also have stop, refresh, zoom. So if you want to see it in the full screen, you can use that option, full screen option. And if you want to come out of full screen, you will press the F11 key and you will be back in the normal view. So once you are in full screen and you want to come back to normal view, you will press F11 as is being shown in the video. Then in the favorites option, you can organize your links and you can add any favorites. If you want to use some address regularly, then you can add here in the favorites so that it's easily available to you. Then next is the tools option. So we will see in the video. Once again, we want to press the Alt button to show the menus. So the next is the tools option. So here you have things like delete browsing history. If you don't want to keep on your computer the history of the usage that you have been using on internet, then you can select what all you want to delete and then press on the delete button. So it will delete all the history from here. So select and delete. The other options are there. For instance, pop-up blocker, manage add-ons. You will learn more about this. There are internet options. Then comes the option for help. So if you need any help with Internet Explorer, you can click here. You can get to know more about Internet Explorer. So you can get all the information that you need. So this is how you will be making use of the menu bar of any browser. In fact, you can see here on the right side, there's also a button for tools. So if you want to hide or show the tools, you can use this option also. For instance, there is full screen. And if in the view menu, if you select the toolbar, it won't get hidden. So it makes it easier for you. So this is how you will be using the menu bar of your web browser. The next option is that of the address bar. Using the address bar, you can open any web page or website directly. For doing this, you must know the domain name or domain network system or DNS correctly of that web page. You need to type that address in the address bar, and using the same, you can reach the desired page. For example, if you want to get to the Google home page, then you will type www.google.com and press the enter button. The Google home page will open. Internet address is also called website. You may be wondering, what is a website? A website can have many web pages which identifies that the domain or the address given by you is correct or not. Each website has a home page, and these home pages can be of different types on different computers. This appearance of the home page depends on the settings of the browser, which can be used to define which should be the first page to be displayed when you open the browser. If you want, you can set up the home page to suit your requirements. A web address is divided into four parts. For example, let us consider the address http://www.google.in. You can see the four parts in this: HTTP, www, Google, and in. The first part, HTTP. HTTP is the most commonly used protocol, and it stands for Hypertext Transfer Protocol. The second part is www. www refers to the World Wide Web site. The third part is Google. This is the main part of the address, and this relates to the server and site address. And the last part is in. This tells you the country to which this site relates, and in implies India. Now you have learned about the address bar, and using the address bar you can open any desired web page. As you know, using the internet you can obtain any information that you need. You can search for information on any subject. You can get to know the news from all across the world. All of you must be wondering how all this information is searched for on the internet. Let us now get to know about some search engines. These are Google, Yahoo, Bing, Gore, Baidu, etc. These are all search engines, and you can find the information you are looking for by typing in the search engine. Google is the most used search engine. Google is well known amongst users. Any user who wants to use Google can type www.google.com in the address bar and press the Enter button. This will open the Google homepage, and then you need to type in the search box what you are looking for. As soon as you press Enter, you are shown many links which contain the information that you are looking for. For instance, if you want information about computer Shiksha on Google, you will first open the browser. Then you need to type Google in it and type computer Shiksha in its search box and press the Enter button. You will be shown links related to information about computer Shiksha. So far you have learned about the browser and the internet. Let us next learn how you can download a file using the internet. The method to download is easy. Once you have learned to use the browser and the internet, you can download easily. First, you need to open the browser and make use of the browser you are interested in using. Once the browser is open, the web will be available. Now, you need to type the address of the search engine that you want to use in the address bar and then press Enter. Next, type what you need to download in the search box. You will be shown a link for the same, and then you need to click on the download option, and your document, file, video, or song will get downloaded. Let us now watch this video and see how we can use the Internet Explorer search box to search for any information. For this, we first have to open the Internet Explorer browser. So, as is being shown in the video, take your pointer to the Internet Explorer icon, which is here at the bottom in the status bar. Click on that. And you see that the Internet Explorer page opens. You can see all the information is here. There are lots of news items, pictures, all the information that is on the home page of the Internet Explorer. Now you have the address bar on top and you also have a search box. So you can type the information that you're looking for in either the search box, or as we are doing, we are typing it in the address box, in the address bar. So we are typing www.google.com and we press enter, and you can see the Google homepage opens. So you can see the Google homepage. Now if you want to search for any information, you can type in the Google search box here. For instance, we want to find information about computer shiksha. So we will just type computer shiksha as is being shown in the video and press enter. So all the links which are related to computer shiksha will be shown here. So you can scroll up and down and you can see a number of links are there for computer shiksha information. So we can click on one of these links. For instance, we have clicked on the first one, which is for computer shiksha, and you can see all the information about computer shiksha is available here. Again, you can scroll up or down on this page and you can get all the required information that you need about computer shiksha. So this way we can use a web browser, the search box or the address bar to open any information page that we need. If we want to open another one, we've just clicked on the address box, press backspace, and then we type the new address. This time we are typing www.amazon.in. So this, when we press enter, you can see it opens the Amazon India page for you. So now you have all the information which is about Amazon available to you on your computer. So this is how you can use the address bar and the search box. Let us now learn how we can download from the internet the Adobe Reader, OpenOffice, Apache and VLC files. With the help of this video, we are going to now learn how we can download files from the internet, for instance, the Adobe Reader. For this, you first have to open any internet browser. So, for instance, here we have taken a pointer and clicked on Google Chrome, the browser for Google. So, you can see the Google homepage has opened. Now, there is an address bar and also a search box is available. So, whatever you want to type, whatever information you're looking for, you can type either directly in the search box or, like we are doing in this video, we are typing in the address bar. Since we want to download the Adobe Reader, we are writing in the address bar, download Adobe Reader. And once we have written this, we will press the enter key. As soon as we press the enter key, you can see many links which are available for anything which is related to Adobe Reader download. So there are many links available. If you scroll down, you will see that many links are available, but most usually the best option is available right on top. So we can click the first link that is being shown here. As you can see in the video, we are clicking on the first link. Once you click there, the web page for Adobe Reader download opens up, as is being shown in the video to you. And here you can see that there is an option for install now. There is a button which says install now. It may for some time show you something like this, an error message saying the site can't be reached. So you can click on the install now button and your file, the Adobe Reader, starts getting downloaded. But now you can see that the download has begun, and on the left bottom side you can see that the download window is being shown, where it says Adobe Reader, it's being downloaded. It also shows you how much the file is, the size of the file, and how much has been downloaded. On the right side at the bottom of the screen, you also have an option of show all the downloads that you have done or are doing. So you can click there and you can see right on top the first option here, or the first portion shows that the Adobe Down Reader has been downloaded or is being downloaded. You can click there and use that to install it. Let us now watch this video and learn how we can download the VLC media player. Again, for doing this, we first have to open one of our browsers for the internet. So you can choose any. In this video, we are choosing Google Chrome. So we take a pointer there and click on it. And you can see the Google Chrome homepage, Google opens. Now you have the address bar and you also have the search box on the Google page. So you can type the information that you're looking for. We're looking for download of VLC media player. So we can type it, like right now we are typing it in the address bar. You can type it in the address bar or in the search box. So we have typed download VLC media player. And then we will press the enter key. As soon as you press the enter key, many links which are related to VLC media player and for downloading the VLC media player open here. So you can scroll down on this page to see all the links which are available. Usually the first link is the most optimal or the best link available. So we can, if we want to download, we will click on one of these links. And it's usually the best to click on the first link here. So it says download VLC media player free. So let's use this link. Click on that. And you will see that the VLC media player page opens. You can see this page is opening. Again, scroll down this page to take a look at options available. You can see what all information is available. Also, you should look for a button which is available for download. Click on that and your download begins. So you know that the download has begun. If you look at the bottom side of your screen on the left side, you can see that the download is happening. Here it shows the file name of the download files, and you can see the same file name appears in this box here, which is showing you that the download is happening. Now if you want to check where this download is happening, just minimize this window and then double click on my computer option or computer option and look in the downloads folder. From the address box, just look in the downloads folder. You can see the last one here is the VLC media player. So it has been downloaded at this location. So this is how you will use the internet browsers to download the VLC media player. Watching this video, we will now see how we can download the Apache OpenOffice software. So first we are clicking on one of the browsers. We have clicked on Google Chrome. So the Google homepage opens. Now you have the option of typing your required address or information that you're looking for, either in the address bar or in the search box for Google. So you can type your address in any of these portions or the information that you're looking for. So we're typing in the address bar. We are saying download. All that we know is that we want OpenOffice. So we'll just say download OpenOffice and then press the enter button on our keyboard. As soon as you press the enter button, you will see many links which are related to Apache OpenOffice or for downloading the same open up here. If you scroll down on this page, you can see the other links which are available. In fact, at the bottom, you can go to the next page and see more links available. But however, usually the first link is the best link or the best possible possibility. So let's click on Apache OpenOffice official download. So left click on that and you will see that the Apache OpenOffice page opens. So it shows various options here. The whole page, the entire information is here. You can scroll down and see other information which is available on this page. As you can see, right on top, we have options for download. So you, in the green area, you can see download Apache OpenOffice. And it has two buttons, download full installation or download language pack. So since we want the full installation, we have clicked on the download full installation. So it shows you that the download has started and there are options available here. You can see the symbol for Apache OpenOffice and the download options available. If you look at the bottom of the screen on the left side, you can see the download window, or it shows you the download which is happening. So this way you can use any of the browsers to download the Apache OpenOffice software. It is downloading right now. Now, if you want to see where it is downloaded, you can just minimize this window and on the main screen on your desktop, look for computer, click on that, double click on that and go to downloads folder. So you can see in the downloads folder, you can click there and you can see that the Apache OpenOffice has been downloaded here. So this is how you will use any of the browsers to download the Apache OpenOffice software. If you need to search for a video or a song, then you will use YouTube for doing so. How will you open YouTube? For doing this, you will type the link for its address in the browser's address bar. You need to type www.youtube.com and press enter. This will open the YouTube page. Or if you like, you can directly type the link of the YouTube in the search box of Google. This will also take you to the YouTube link. What is email? Email is short for electronic mail. Using email, you can communicate with others. You use email very much like writing a letter. When you did not have phones, people used to write down all that they had to communicate and then they would write the address where they want to send the information. Email works in almost a similar manner. You type out the information you want to convey and then you need the email address of the person you want to send it to. Using this communication method, you can communicate with your family and friends who are far away from you. You can share anything you like with them. For doing this, you need to have an email ID. Email ID is a means using which you can connect to another person on the net. Let us now watch the video and learn how we make an email ID and then how we can make use of it. This next video is very interesting because it helps us to understand how to create an account, an email account. So open any browser. You can either open it from the taskbar or by clicking on the icons which are on the desktop. So you can open any browser. Right now we have opened Google Chrome. So you see the Google homepage is open. As you know, there is an address bar and a search box in Google. So you can type the information that you're looking for either in the address bar or in the search box. So we are typing in the address bar Gmail. That is one of the email possibilities that we can use. So we have typed Gmail, click on and press enter. So you see a lot of links related to Gmail. Now, if you look at the first link, there is a sign saying AD, which actually is for an advertisement. So you can scroll up and down. And in this case, the best link is the second link, which says Gmail Google. So let's click on Gmail Google to create an account, because the first one is actually an advertisement. So when we click there, some accounts which are already there are showing up here. Since we want to create a new account, we click on add account. Once you click here, it shows you an option saying, do you want to log in? But if you look, since we don't have an account, we can't log in. So it is showing you an option of create account. So click on create account. Then it asks you for some information about yourself to be able to open the account. So first you see, you need to type your first name and last name. So in our case, we are just going to type computer as first name and Shiksha as the last name. So we have typed computer Shiksha. Then you need to choose a username that you want to see on your email or when you send email. So we have typed computer.shiksha777 and our whole username will be computer.shiksha777@gmail.com. Now we have to create a password. Remember that the password should be at least 8 characters long. So type in the password and then in the second box which says confirm your password, type in the same password that you have created first. If you don't type the same, an error will show. Now it asks you to type in your birth details, birth date. So we have selected the month of August, the date we select 15th August and the year. So you need to type in your date of birth. The next one is gender. So you have to select male or female. Click there. And then it asks for a mobile number so that it can send you confirmation, or if you forget your password, etc., it can help you on this mobile number. So we type in a mobile number which you use. For instance, for computer Shiksha, the helpline number is 99106-23004. So we have typed that. And if you don't have a current email address, you can ignore that. Choose the location where you are located. When you click here, you can see that it shows you options for so many countries. So you can select India, for instance. In our case, so we have selected India here by clicking on the India option. Then it says next step, so click on the next step. Now it shows you the terms, privacy and terms. Any site that you sign on to will have its own terms of use. So you should take a look through these terms and then you have to agree to the terms. So click on I agree. Then it takes you to the next page, which is the verification page. So you can opt for getting a SMS message on the mobile number. Continue. And now it says enter the verification code in the next page. So you will receive on your mobile a verification code. That code you type in here, like we are showing you in the video. We are typing the code which we have received on our mobile. And once you have typed that, you can click on confirm. Click on continue. So once you click on continue, your Gmail account has been made. So it is now showing you your new email address is so and so. So continue to Gmail, click on that button, and your account is being loaded. You can see your account computershiksha777@gmail.com. It shows you a welcome sign, and then here it shows you what all you can do with your Gmail account. You have an inbox, you can compose a new message, you have sent mail, and you have so many other options available here. So now you can start using your Gmail account. Remember your password and start using. With the help of this next video, let us now see how we can use our Gmail account to send messages. So you can see options here, compose, sent mail. Right now there's no sent mail, but in the inbox you can see that there are three mails for you already. So if you want to send a new mail, we will have to click on the compose button. So let's take a pointer there and click on compose, as is being shown in the video. And you can see a box opens which says new message. In this, on the top there are three options: minimize, full screen, or close. So if we click on minimize, this message, the new box message or new message box will be down here. So you can click again on the maximize button now, and it will show you here. You can obviously use the maximize button. Now there are two options here, to and subject. So in the to column, you have to type the email ID of the person or the organization where you are sending the email. It's like the address that you used to write on your letter. So we are typing this to connect@computershiksha.org. The next is subject. So you can type the subject matter related to what you are typing, the message that you are typing. So we are saying for testing. And then here in the main body of the box, you can type the text of your message. For instance, here we are just going to type, let's say, hello. And you can see down below, there are other options available. There are icons for different options. One of the options here is for formatting. So the text that you are typing in this box, you can select that text and use the formatting option to format it. The next option is for attaching files. We will learn about these. So we have selected the text. Then when you click on the formatting option, you can change the font style. You can make it larger or huge, large size. So depending on, first you need to select the text. You can make it bold by clicking on B option, bold option. Click on I for italics to make it italics, and click on U for underline so you can underline it. Then there are options for the text color. So once you click here, there are many colors available. So you can choose the color that you want the text to be and click on that. Also, there is an option for alignment. Then there is an option for attach files. So once you click there, it shows you, you have to tell the computer where your file is. So we are saying, we are opening the box where the address box is. So you can choose which document, you should know where you want to pick the document from, which you want to attach. So we are looking in the desktop right now. Similarly, we can look in documents folder by clicking on documents and then choose the file that you want to attach. So here we are trying to look at different options here. We are going to downloads, and in the downloads, we have clicked on contact address file. Click on open and you can see the file gets attached. It is getting attached in our email. Now, all you have to do, once your message is ready, click on send. And once you click on send, your message will get sent along with this attachment, the attached file, to connect at Computer Shiksha. So you can see here, it shows you a message. Your message has been sent. So this is how you can use the Gmail account. Since today's class will end here, properly shut down your computer. Computer Shiksha is supported by. Thank you.